A fire at a tire recycling facility continues to burn tonight in Port St. Lucie.
Firefighters have been out there all evening battling not only the flames, but also the heat. Alexis Rivera has the latest.
The orange flames can be seen from miles away, smoke pouring out into the sky. This fire has been going for hours, and with no immediate end in sight, crews will be out here working overnight. A thick blanket of smoke rises from this Port St. Lucie tire recycling plant. Half an acre of the property is on fire.
We've got three engines, two tankers, a water tender, a rescue truck.
All hands are on deck to get the flames under control. About 30 firefighters are battling the intense heat, pumping thousands of gallons of water on mounds of tires, trying to control the blaze.
Heat is a big issue. We've got them rotating in and out now, so we've got rehab set up, and that's good. So we pull them in, let them get some rest, let the other firefighters out there working.
The St. Lucie County Fire District arrived late Tuesday afternoon to the Florida tire recycling plant with several more hours of work ahead. According to the fire chief, tire fires are hard to fight.
They get deep-seated and it's very challenging, so they put a lot of water on them and spread out the material and try to quench it.
The Red Cross was called in to assist, providing food and water for the men and women on the scene.
We work hand-in-hand together, all the other, you know, situations, so why not for this when they really need it?
As night falls, the smoke continues billowing. The flames shoot up, lighting up the sky. A sign to fire teams, their job is far from over. Now, according to the fire chief, the fire out here started when some employees were moving materials out here, and he says they just spontaneously combusted and went up in flames. Now, we did receive a statement from the company. They tell us that some employees actually discovered the fire out here in the yard. They called 911 immediately. They also tell us none of the buildings on the property have been affected, and all of their employees are safe and accounted for. In Port St. Lucie, Alexis Rivera, WPBF 25 News.